but I will continue the long-standing executive branch practice of not disclosing information that may be subject to executive privilege,
and that such communications are within the core of executive privilege.
The president's power to exert executive privilege is very well established.
Mentions of executive privilege are rampant as congressional panels take up more rigorous investigations of President Trump and his associates. And they often lead to friction between members of Congress and the administration.
This administration is used to evading any questions they want to evade.
This is not executive privilege, this is executive stonewalling.
Congress has expansive power to investigate legislative and oversight matters. But that power can clash with the president's executive privilege to protect certain confidential and sensitive communications. The Constitution doesn't specifically address legislative oversight or executive privilege, but the Supreme Court has examined both in the past, like during the Watergate investigations and after the congressional hearings motivated by McCarthyism in the 1950s. Since those and other cases, executive privilege has largely taken precedence in instances that protect national security and White House deliberations, but not when it inhibits Congress's constitutional powers or doesn't closely involve the president. In past congressional inquiries, President Trump has been hesitant to officially invoke executive privilege in advance, but has still withheld documents and areas of testimony during hearings.
The president has asserted executive privilege the first time we've had to face this up here on a nominee from either Republicans or Democrats. Of 102,000 pages of material, 102,000.
Now Trump's legal team faces a new test with the House Judiciary Committee's broad request for documents and communications related to the president, his campaign, and his transition. Their wide net investigates not just Russia-related events, but also potential obstruction of justice, corruption, and abuse of power, like the firing of FBI Director James Comey and the hush payments to women. The White House legal team has staffed up to prepare for the aggressive congressional oversight from Democrats, and is focused on limiting the investigation's scope, preserving Trump's legal protections, and asserting executive privilege only when necessary. Because contested claims of executive privilege often end up winding their way through lengthy court battles, the White House and Congress could negotiate terms for sensitive information behind closed doors. But if they don't reach agreements, Congress has the power to escalate its request to subpoenas, and then to hold uncooperative parties in contempt to try and force the information out into the public.
All right, let's do something. Hey, it's Wesley Lowry of the Washington Post here. Make sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel to get all of our latest reporting, analysis, and stay up to date on what's going on in the world around you.
Have you read all those books?
No, not even close.